lot of scouts out there evaluating you, but how would you evaluate yourself after today?
I thought it went okay. I missed some throws, but for the most part, it was fun to get out there again with those guys. Just be able to throw and do stuff that we haven't been able to do in the last month and a half. So it was enjoyable.
What are some throws that you're focusing on as you get set for this process?
There's not really one particular throw. We just try to showcase as much as we could to the team.
Weird for you to be huddling under center.
It was a little different, but again, it was fun. For us, it's a unique round for us, so we get to be able to enjoy that and start to get used to those things. It was fun.
Is it as uncomfortable as you thought? You mentioned at the combine, you thought the huddle might be the biggest adjustment. I mean, was it comfortable?
Yeah, it's tough. I did it when I was a kid, so it's not something that's extremely new to me. It's fun to be in that group again and then call the play and be able to do that.
How about the drops? How comfortable do you feel making throws after, five and seven step drops?
I thought I did well. I think, stuff that, you begin to learn, once the season was done. And I thought that it's something that I've gained, gotten a lot more comfortable with.
How do you eliminate all the noise? There's been so much talk about your ability to, deal with the pro defenses and the stuff with Coach Kelly yesterday with the trades they made. There's been so much speculation about where you're going to go. How do you tune all that out?
Just not pay attention to it. You can't control it. It's something that this process is something that is controlled by other people. So all you really can do is, put yourself out there, show what you can do, and then see where you end up.
Any reaction to that with Chip saying you're the best quarterback in the draft?
That was really nice of him. When I see him, I thank him for it.
Do you think about potentially playing for him if the chips fall that way?
Yeah, we'll see what happens. But again, it's not something that I can control.
Marcus, what's the comfort working with Kevin O'Connell like today?
It was awesome. I haven't been able to be on the field with him in a few weeks since he took the job with Cleveland. But it was good to have him out there. He's been a tremendous help.
What are the things you did today that you kind of coaching you in January that focus on?
Yeah, definitely just, he always helping me with footwork and kind of keeping my base, solid, moving in the pocket. So a lot of those things, it's tough to see on a pro day, but it's things that I've been doing every day.
You had a chance to sit down with Grant Hall and
A little bit during the combine.
Can you talk about it a little bit, the change from being a student athlete to being a paid professional athlete, how that changes your daily routine, those kinds of things?
Yeah, the biggest difference is you don't have to go to class. You have an opportunity to kind of hone your craft and focus on things that you can continue to work on each and every single day. It is a little different. It's something that you still got to get used to, but it's fun to do. Yes, I'm actually going to meet with them in like 5 minutes. I leave tonight to go to New Jersey and I do kind of like this trip. I don't know yet. I have to wait for this.
Marcus, compare your performance today with the combine.
I thought at the combine I threw better, I think. Today, I think a lot of emotion being back, in Eugene and stuff like that caused maybe some nervousness a little bit. But at the same time, I thought it went well both ways. It was good.
You mentioned it.
Marcus?